Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Mary. In today's video, I'm going to talk about all of my product empties. These are the products that I've collected over the past a little more than 3 months, and I've been postponing this video since quite some time, so I decided to make this the last video of 2021. Most of these products are sample size products, and I've already made detailed reviews of most of these products on my channel, so I'll leave links in the description box below for you. So in case you want more information about any of these products, you'll find those links in the description box. So let's get started with the video. So let's begin with face washes first. The first product that I have is the Mom's Co Vita Rich face wash. I also have the Mom's Co natural clay face wash. Now I did not like the clay based face wash because that was a little bit too drying for me, so I wouldn't recommend it for dry skin, and even for oily skin it isn't a great product. But the Vita Rich face wash is a decent product. It's a very gentle cleanser, but it's just a basic cleanser. There's nothing too great about it. I didn't notice much benefits with these products. Next one I have is the Wow Vitamin C face wash and the Mamaearth Vitamin C face wash. Again, these are two different brands, but they're very similar in the overall texture. Only difference is the fragrance, but the overall everything feels very similar. It gives a little bit of brightening effect. A decent face wash. But if I had to choose between any of these two, then I would choose the Mamaearth one. Next is the Be Body Wise Hydrating Cleanser. This has a strong fragrance, but overall it's a very good face wash, great for the winter, and I highly recommend it for dry skin. Next one is the Coco Soul Revitalizing Face Wash. This one I did not like at all. It is one of the worst face washes that I've tried. It was extremely drying. It was a little bit irritating my skin also, all the acne breakouts that I was having that time. It wasn't working that great, so I don't recommend this face wash at all. Next two face washes is the Mamaearth Latte face wash and the Espresso face wash. Again, two face washes extremely similar. The only difference between these two face washes are the texture and the fragrance. Apart from that, the overall formulation is very similar. But as a face wash, it's a nice, decent ones, and hydrating. It's not too drying. Cleanses the face very well. So these were all of the face washes in my empties. Now I have two shower gels. The first one is this Coco Soul shower gel. Now if I compare with the other Coco Soul products that I've tried, the shower gel is a decent one. It worked well. Next shower gel is the Pure Sense body cleansing gel. I really like this one. It is a very nice, gentle body cleanser. It cleanses very well, lathers quite decently. I love the fragrance of this one. It has a nice fruity fragrance. Overall, a great product. Moving on to moisturizers, the first moisturizer that I emptied, and I had it since a very long time, is a Neutrogena oil free moisturizer. This is a very good fragrance free moisturizer. It is non oily, non greasy. Highly recommend this for oily to combination skin. Another favorite fragrance free moisturizer of mine is the Plum oil free moisturizer. This is one of their new launches. I really love this moisturizer. It's great for summer, for oily skin. It works really well. Extremely lightweight, non oily, non greasy, works well under the makeup. Highly recommend this one. One of the best moisturizers that I've tried, and it also contains choline and niacinamide, so it gives a lot of added benefits too. Next moisturizer is a Dot & Key 72 hours hydrating gel. It's a gel based, water based moisturizer. It's a good one. The only thing is it does contain a very strong fragrance, so it may not work for sensitive skin. Next one is a Dermacol Ceramide face moisturizer. This one, it broke me out, so I don't recommend this at all for oily, for sensitive skin. I don't recommend this at all because it didn't work for me. I had to use it as a hand cream, body lotion, so I finished it off that way. It has a very strong fragrance. It's a very thick moisturizer. It would work for dry skin if you don't have sensitive skin. Next one is a Cetaphil moisturizing lotion. This can be used as a body lotion as well as a face moisturizer, but when I used it, it was a little bit too thick for me because my skin is oily and this is mostly for dry skin. So I would recommend this moisturizing lotion for dry skin. Works great as a body lotion as well. Next one is the M Caffeine Cappuccino Moisturizer. As a moisturizer, it works well. It has a fragrance of cappuccino coffee. Next two products are a body butter, and I did not like the Chrono Clay body butter. It wasn't a great product, doesn't smell that great. It is more like a body lotion. Next one is the Mom's Co body butter. This one is a bit too thick, and it's really nice body butter. Again, the fragrance of this one also is not that great. नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज फेशियल ऑयल्स एंड सीरम्स. आई लव द ट्राइब कॉन्सेप्ट कुमकुमादि तैलम फेशियल ऑयल. दिस इज नॉट ओनली मॉइस्चराइजिंग फेशियल ऑयल, हाइड्रेटिंग फेशियल ऑयल, बट इट ऑल्सो इज लाइक अ मल्टीपर्पज फेशियल ऑयल. इट ऑल्सो हील्ड अप अ लॉट ऑफ एक्ने, एक्टिव एक्ने दैट आई हैड. नेक्स्ट इज अ ब्लू नेक्टर फेशियल मिस्ट. दिस इज अ नाइस फेशियल मिस्ट, डजंट कंटेन एनी फ्रेग्रेंस, नाइस प्रोडक्ट. नेक्स्ट एमटी इज द जस्ट हर्ब्स एंटी ब्लेमिश ब्लेमी जेल. दिस वर्क्स ऑन डार्क स्पॉट्स. इट डिड नॉट वर्क ऑन एक्टिव एक्ने. इट डज कंटेन ऑरेंज पील एज वन ऑफ द इंग्रेडिएंट्स. सो यू नीड टू यूज सनस्क्रीन द नेक्स्ट डे इन द मॉर्निंग इफ यू आर यूजिंग दिस इन द नाइट एज अ ट्रीटमेंट. नेक्स्ट सेंट बोटानिका 2% सैलिसिलिक एसिड फेशियल सीरम. दिस वन आई डिड नॉट लाइक एट ऑल. इट इज़ अ हाईली ओवर प्राइज वन. इट डजेंट वर्क ऑन एक्टिव एक्ने. इट डजेंट वर्क इन हीलिंग अप ऑफ एक्ने और ऑन डार्क स्पॉट्स. एंड इट इज़ हाईली परफ्यूम्ड वन. इट वुडेंट वर्क फॉर पीपल विद सेंसिटिव एक्ने प्रोन स्किन एट ऑल. Next is a Claire's Midnight Blue Calming Cream. Now this is like a moisturizing cream, but I used it mostly like a spot treatment, and it does work on active acne, but it didn't work on like old acne, but on active acne it does work in healing them up, but not on all types of acne. So I wouldn't recommend this, but if you want to use it as a moisturizing cream, I would recommend this for dry skin. It won't work for oily skin because it's a bit too thick as a moisturizing cream. Next, I also tried the Priveda Acne Pimple Patch. I've reviewed it on my Instagram account. I did not make a detailed review on YouTube, but it's a nice product. It's very decent. It works on active acne. It heals up. You have to use it 2 to 3 times to see for the acne to start healing up. It's an overall a really nice product. Next, moving on to hair care. First, I have shampoo. The first one is the Mom's Co Damage Repair Shampoo. It's an overall good product. Very nice. It's a very gentle cleanser. Very mild fragrance also. I really like this one. But if you have like, if you're using a very thick hair oil, then it may not work that well to remove it off completely. But as a gentle hair cleanser, this is really nice. Another shampoo is the Mamaearth Rice Water Shampoo. This one also I liked. It's a nice shampoo. It has a very nice floral fragrance. It's very well balanced shampoo. Last product but not the least is a Bee Body Wise hair oil. This works great as a hair oil. Very lightweight. It also helps in controlling hair fall. So that is all from my overall product empties. I hope you found this video to be useful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe for more such skincare reviews and a lot of product empties, and you'll find a lot of these videos from the description box below. And that is all for today. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.